What's going on, everybody? My name is Cloudy, and welcome to a new video. Today, I have a really good topic for you guys, or life story, whatever you want to call it. And today's life story is actually about how I got lost in an elevator on vacation. Now, this is crazy, guys. This is honestly, like, I don't know how this happened. Like, I just got stuck, and I just got lost, and I didn't know where I was or what was going on. I was 5 years old, guys. This was a long time ago, to be honest. And it was crazy. It was honestly crazy. So before I get on with the story, I just wanted to say, last video I had a problem with my audio. I'm really sorry, guys. I'm gonna fix it this video. And I promise you it'll get fixed and that it'll be better this video. I think it was a render problem. I'm not really sure, but we're back at it again, and hopefully it'll be better this time around. So last gameplay, I had a friend that helped me out with the gameplay, Voftable. I just want to give you a big thanks, Voftable. Thank you for helping. You're a really cool guy. You're a really good friend of mine, and I just want to say thanks, Blue Slime, for helping out, and for my new gameplay that I just recorded. This one is with a friend, Lucky Cloud, and he helped me out. I just want to say thank you to you too, Lucky Cloud. So, guys, I like doing this little life story stuff. I think it's really fun, and it's just a really good way for me to connect with you guys and pretty much give you a little bit of information about my life, and maybe it can relate to you, and maybe you can have some type of relation to it, and that's really cool when I do that, because it's really fun to see what your perspective of my stories are, and I really like that. It's fun to connect, you know. It's what YouTube's for, and it's what I like to do. So I really want to get started on today's story, guys, because we got a lot of time on our hands, and this video is going to be pretty long. Maybe, I'm not really sure. I might have to, you know, it'll go by. So let me start off by saying, okay, I don't really know what happened when I went on vacation. This was in, where was this at? I think this was in Mexico. This was in Mexico. Okay, so this is in Mexico. I was 5 years old, and anyway, sorry for that quick little pause, guys. But so yeah, I'm really excited to give you guys another life story, and I can't wait to just talk about it. So I like doing this for you guys. I like doing this. This is really fun, and it's just really nice to connect with you guys. So let me first start off by saying, yeah, I said I went to Mexico. So when I went to Mexico, you know, let me start off the day. So I woke up, you know, it was a normal day, guys. I, like any other day, I woke up, except it was really early. It had to be about like 5-6 o'clock in the morning, and a.m. to be exact. And I went to the airport like a normal vacation. So when I went to the airport, you know, I was kind of like confused, like, this is my first vacation, like, I'm actually going on vacation, like, this is actually going to be really fun. I'm thinking to myself, like, damn, this is going to be so much fun. And then I started thinking more about it, and I'm just like, I hope I don't get, like, lost or anything, because, like, my parents, like, I'm five, so they kind of had me a couple years ago when I was born, and I feel like my parents, like, when I was younger, they didn't leave me, they just kind of let me do my own thing. I mean, that happens when you get older usually, not when you're younger, but I feel like when I was really young, my parents did that, because, you know, when you're young, like, you want to have fun, you know, you don't want to waste your days doing stupid stuff, like, that's what I'm doing, like, now, pretty much, like, I do homework every day, like, it's not stupid, it's just, it's not as fun as having fun when you're younger. So let me start off by saying we went to Mexico, and then when we arrived there, you know, we got our luggage and everything. The plane ride was really good. It was very smooth. I really liked it. So we got our luggage and everything, and here comes the fun part. So we got our luggage and everything, and I feel like the workers were really young, and young workers, I'm not, guys, no offense to us, but our generation with young workers, we are so screwed. I just went to Panera the other day, and then I went to Dairy Queen, and I have two things I have to say about young workers. First of all, we are very lazy, and we don't do the right thing, and we don't listen, we don't, like, repeat what we're gonna do. Like, for example, I went to Dairy Queen and I asked for pineapples, and they only gave me fudge. That's it. And I paid for the pineapples. I'm not being like harsh about it. I'm just saying, like, if I say pineapples, you should probably put pineapples if I'm paying for it. Another example, I went to Panera Bread. They were out of 5 soups. That means they're not making the soup. Anyway, let's get back to the Mexican story or the lost elevator story. So we got our luggage and we are ready to go to the room. So, you know, my parents are like, hey, they have new elevators in this hotel. And that's so cool at a hotel. Like, I'm so new to this stuff. I'm just like, oh my gosh, I've never been in an elevator at a hotel before. And this is my first time. So my parents took the stairs and I didn't even know it because I'm so fascinated with this elevator. Like, oh my gosh, I want to go on this thing. This thing is so cool. Like, people are looking at me like I'm crazy. Like, is he okay? So I go on the underground elevator and my parents are walking up the stairs, and what do you know? I get stuck on the elevator. Okay, so I'm pushing buttons, not knowing what I'm doing, not even concerned about what's going on. I'm just doing what I want to do and blah blah blah, going by myself like a little kid as I am, just having fun pushing buttons. And I ended up at the last floor, all the way at the top, and I didn't even know where I was. And I got out and I saw people there and I was confused. I was scared. I was like, oh my gosh, where am I and where is this? Like, this does not look familiar. And then I looked for my parents and I couldn't find him. And then I went back on the elevator. So I'm looking around and I'm just like, I don't know what's going on. What's happening? I was so confused and I didn't know what was going on. So I went back on the elevator, guys. I had to. What was I gonna do? Just stand there and not do anything? I went back on the elevator and yes, I did. I went on the elevator, hit another button. I think it was the first floor, and then guess what? My parents weren't on the first floor, so this started to get really fun. So then I had to go to the desk, and I was just like, I can't find mommy, and they said, they were looking at me, they were like, what do we do? And we just checked out, so they said the room number to me, and I'm thinking in my head, like, where is that at? I don't even know where that's at. So then they ended up taking me to the room. And eventually I got to the room and I found my parents, and it was just hectic because, like, I didn't know where I was going. I was lost in the elevator on vacation, and I just wasted about 2 hours of my time on vacation when I could have been in the pool or in the ocean just relaxing and spending my day the way it should have been. And the worst part about this is it was my mom's birthday when we went, so I honestly felt really bad for my mom because, like, she's trying to have fun and I'm getting her all worried and wrecked up just because I'm gone, like, I'm lost. And my parents were freaking out too. They were like, where did Caroline go? Is she here? Where did she go? Because, like, they know that I like to do that kind of stuff. Like, they know that I liked to, you know, not doze off, but, you know, just have a little time to myself. I'm not really a social butterfly as I am now, but I used to be kind of to myself, and I really changed throughout the past years. So, yeah, guys, I hope you enjoyed this story. And yeah, I got lost on the elevator, so I'm pretty sure it's happened to you guys. It'll probably happen to your friends, or your cousins, or your sisters or brothers. It happens to people. You know, you get stuck someplace and it's hard to find your family, if that makes any sense. I don't even know. But anyways, hope you enjoyed this crazy, cool, fun story, guys. And I hope to see you in the next video. And my name is Caroline, or Cloudy, and thanks for watching. Stay cloudy. What's going on, everybody? My name is Cloudy and welcome to a new video. Today I have a really good topic.